everyone, I'm Taron, and this is Lord of the Springs, inside of MuLab. Yep, that's probably, no, most certainly my favorite DAW, and you should go check it out if you haven't yet on mutools.com. Alright, what we're gonna do today are drums. Yes, with Lord of the Springs, of course. And to do that, let's just start over from scratch by making a brand new project and clean it up a little bit. There we go. And to do drums, I actually have developed that habit to go straight to the modular area of MuLab. And I make a little bit of room and add a sweet little template I made myself. Maybe I should post this, I don't know. And it's super simple. I mean, you can easily do that yourself. It's not much work. And it consists out of a keypad or notepad. Actually, let me look what that actually... What's the name of this event generator? It's Note Event Pad. Ta-da, like so. All right. A Note Event Pad. And a little note modifier that helps us transpose a note if need be. Okay, so now let's get started, and we add an instance of Lord of the Springs and hook it into our C4 and the output into audio output 1. I have a second one because I like using that to sidechain the kick drum. Why not connect it now? It doesn't matter. All right, but let's have a quick look here. All right, in the modular area, we also want to connect the output 1 to the master, and so we're practically done. No, doesn't sound like much yet. And here we have it. So, let's start by turning spring B all the way off, and the balance of spring A to minus 1, so we hear only one single spring, and it is this one here, our bass spring. We need this one because we're gonna use a modulation envelope. Ta-da! On pitch. And we make it a bit faster. Now, back to spring A, and I turn the decay down. And that makes us hear the body. We don't want that now. Alright, and now we turn our stereo spread to 0 so that the drum is in the center. Make it a bit louder. Maybe way louder. Alright. And let's use the note modifier to transpose that one down. Well, it's a nice one. But you will want to tune that to your song's tonic or however, wherever you'd like to have it. Okay, that's almost juicy, but not much yet. So let's make this a bit more interesting by using spring B. But not like that. Let's turn diffuse of spring B all the way to noise. And bring the noise frequency up. And the noise resonance down. Okay. Almost interesting. Let's take the decay of noise spring B down, so we just get a little tick. There we go. Alright, so we have a bit of a kick drum already. Now, I found out something really neat by using the body. That sounds wrong, but anyway. So, and we can use the body, and you see the lowest key and highest key, that's the range of springs that are hooked to the body's imaginary frame. And we can reduce that so that only the springs in the bottom give us a bit of extra body. Isn't that neat? And let's make this tighter, turning the decay down. Alright, and then add to taste. Without, with. Okay. Right, so that would be our kick drum. Let's call it kick two. Ta-da! So, now, let's make a snare. We add another instance of Lord of the Springs, and I hook it to D. Yeah, I'm really faithful to the good old General MIDI. But yeah, except for the octaves, of course. We are in the fourth, anyhow. So, D. And it sounds like this. Not much of a snare yet. So, let's start again by turning spring A's balance to minus one. So we only have one spring. And the spring B, again, the diffuse, we turn all the way up to noise. And let's bring the resonance down first. And then the noise frequency all the way up. All right, that's very long for a snare. Decay down of spring A. See? Let's turn the body down for a second. Noise way up. Maybe a bit of extra boost. And it's a tiny bit tighter. Almost interesting. Okay. Let's go into the modulation envelope and we give it a tiny bit of pitch envelope. Well, like so. And now, for the first time, we shall use also the secondary spring of spring A, but tune it differently. I dig putting it on C sharp. It's like a major terz to the bass. And so it's a nice harmonic relationship. And I turn this way down and instead give it a tiny bit of, in the envelope, a tiny bit of balance kick there. We can turn the spread to 0/2 so that it's centered. And then what I like doing is give it a tiny bit of delay. Not that kind. A sync, a very tight one, with a little bit of stereo offset. So it gets a bit of depth. And I actually have found out that using the body for the snare is also quite cool, except we're just gonna use the higher springs to get that ringing. And also tighter. Can you hear that? And you can tune that to your liking, of course. All right, so we have a snare. Now let's add one more instance so we can finish up our basic, super basic drum set by making a hi-hat. And I put it on F sharp, still in my general MIDI. And it sounds like this. Okay, so for the hi-hat, we're gonna turn spring A all the way down, spring B up, diffuse of spring B again to noise. Let's turn the resonance down right away and bring the frequency up. Okay, and the body down. And we make this tighter again. And if you use a noise resonance, there is a sweet spot where it almost sounds like a high pass, or it acts like a high pass. And we take advantage of that. Okay. Alright. Could be even tighter. And now we can do something really interesting, and that is we bring the spring A back up in I bring the secondary tuning very close to the primary tuning, and instead we're gonna use the note modifier there, and we get a bit of this metal ringing, and that is good. And maybe we can even try the body for the hi-hat as well. Really tight, 106 to 108, so just two springs on the body give us a bit of an extra ring. All right, so we have a basic drum set. Let's put it to the test real quick. We go into the racks here and choose the session works drums, our modular drum module as target, and we make a quick little pattern. Ta-da! So, all right. All right. A little bit of dynamics. You are like so, and maybe some hi-hats. Very, very simple. Sure. Let's copy them all over. It's not gonna have to be a brilliant rhythm, just something so we can hear it. Springs. I hope you could get something out of it, and I also hope to see you again soon. When we do, I'm not sure yet, but there's gonna be another one, I'm pretty sure of that. See you then. Bye.